Hear the words of Thich Nhat Hanh. Look at the tree. It is a wonderful thing, a tree. A tree is very beautiful. A tree to me is as beautiful as a cathedral, even more beautiful. I looked into the tree and I saw the whole cosmos. I saw the sunshine in the tree. Can you see the sunshine in the tree? Yes, because without the sunshine, no tree can grow. I see a cloud in the sunshine. I see a cloud in the tree. Can you see? Without a cloud, there can be no rain, no tree. I see the earth in the tree. I see everything in the tree. So the tree is where everything in the cosmos comes into. And the cosmos reveals itself to me through a tree. Therefore, a tree to me is a cathedral, and I can take refuge in the tree, and I can get nourished by the tree. I can get in touch with the tree only if I go back to the present moment, because the tree can only be found in the present.
Let us see the beauty every day and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day, and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day, and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty of
you can see the beauty,
and source our lives from its presence
every day.
Let us see the beauty every day,
you can see the beauty,
and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day,
you can see the beauty,
source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day, and source our light from its presence.
Trust the harmony. I want to know if you can see the beauty, even when it's not pretty every day. I want to know if you can see the beauty, and source your life from its presence.
Let us see the beauty every day, and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day, and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day, and source our lives from its presence. Let us see the beauty every day, and source our lives from its
presence. Disciple in Vietnam who wants to build a stupa for my ashes when I die. He and others want to include a plaque with the words, "Here lies my beloved teacher." I told them not to waste the temple land. "Do not put me in a small pot and put me in there," I said. "I don't want to continue like that. It would be better to scatter the ashes outside to help the trees grow." I suggested that if they still insist on building the stupa, they have the plaque say, "I am not here." But in case people don't get it, they could add a second plaque, "I am not out there." If people still don't understand, then you can write on the third and last plaque, "I may be found in your way of breathing and walking. This body of mine will disintegrate, but my actions will continue me. In my daily life, I always practice to see my continuation all around me. We don't need to wait until the total dissolution of this body to continue. We continue in every moment. If you think I am only this body, then you have not truly seen me. When you look at my friends, you see my continuation. When you see someone walking with mindfulness and compassion, you know they are my continuation. I don't see why we have to say, I will die. Because I can already see myself in you, in other people, and in future generations. It is impossible for a cloud to die. It can become rain or ice, but it cannot become nothing. The cloud does not need to have a soul in order to continue. There's no beginning and no end. I will never die. There will be a dissolution of this body, but that does not mean my death. I will continue always.
This is a three jewels chant. Three jewels of Buddhism. I take refuge in the Buddha. I take refuge in the Dharma. I take refuge in the Sangha. Enlightened being, enlightened teachings, enlightened community.
Saranam, gachami.
Hear the words of Thich Nhat Hanh. When we see that we and all living beings are made of the same nature, how can there be division between us? How can there be lack of harmony? When we realize our interbeing nature, we'll stop blaming and exploiting and killing, because we know that we inter are. That is the great awakening we must have in order for the earth to be saved. We human beings have always singled ourselves out from the rest of the natural world. We classify other animals and living beings as nature, a thing apart from us, and act as if we're somehow separate from it. Then we ask, how should we deal with nature? We should deal with nature the same way we should deal with ourselves, non-violently. Human beings and nature are inseparable. Just as we should not harm ourselves, we should not harm nature. May it be so.
I cannot turn my eyes. I cannot count the cost of all that has been broken, of all that has been lost.
I cannot understand the suffering that life brings. War and hate and hunger. I love.